O guardians of the Watchtower of the East, I, Ishta, High Priestess and Witch, do summon and serve thee. I command thy presence at this, our meeting, to guard over our circle and to witness our rites.
Witchcraft is the fastest growing offshoot of paganism and neo-paganism today. Hundreds of thousands of children and teenagers are joining its ranks according to reports from an ever-increasing number of pagan websites. The Pagan Federation of England claims their mailbags swell by the thousands from charmed teenagers every time a particularly exciting episode of Buffy the Vampire Slayer airs on TV, or an enticing article on witchcraft appears in a popular teen magazine. Witchcraft, or Wicca as it is known, believes in revering the mother goddess, the global environment, feminist practices, and nature. The holy reed or rule, do what you want as long as it harms no one, is Wicca's most appealing draw, encouraging its adherents to indulge in self-gratification and self-centeredness, while allowing morals to shift at will. Wicca teaches there is no absolute truth or sin, and replaces the patriarchal male creator god of the Bible with a belief in both male and female gods. Most pagans and witches believe they must communicate with supernatural spirits, which they refer to as forces of nature, in order to receive wisdom and power for magical skills. They also embrace the concept of self-empowerment by awakening internal spirituality through meditation, visualization, and other mind-altering techniques of self-hypnosis. Dimly lit parlors or New Age fairs are no longer the only places to practice secret magic, fortune-telling, spell-casting, or potion-mixing. As a result of aggressive marketing campaigns, a wide variety of witchcraft techniques offering powers of control for personal achievements can now be found in bookstores, on the internet, in public schools and libraries, and throughout the media. Hollywood's presentation of witchcraft as exciting and glamorous has further increased its appeal to young audiences. Enhanced by digital technology and revolutionary special effects, occultic spells and rituals are given visually stunning portrayals, as are the depictions of supernatural beings, ghosts, demons, vampires, mythological characters, and even Satan. A growing number of cartoons and television dramas aimed at increasingly younger audiences further seduce children with the allure of sorcery and divination. Occultic themes are frequently woven into the storylines of primetime series, which has undoubtedly contributed to the practice of magic as being the fastest growing mystical attraction among teenagers. The spectacular growth of the internet, which occultists refer to as the portal of transcendence, has further fanned the fascination of spiritual alternatives. An unprecedented amount of occult literature is available online. At Amazon.com, for example, consumers can find more than 1,850 books on witchcraft. And in addition, hundreds of websites are dedicated to marketing witchcraft specifically to children. Pagans and witches worldwide can now communicate and perform ritual magic online through an ever-expanding number of highly networked, occult-oriented chat rooms. Countless websites now offer everything from poison rings to spells for young people seeking empowerment. Each year, thousands of teens are turning their backs on Christianity and joining witches' covens in order to learn spells so as to pass school exams, attract boyfriends or girlfriends, and get rich. The secretary of the Magic Circle's Young Magicians Club credits the Harry Potter books as the latest rage, which he says has rekindled the childlike approach to the fact that the impossible may be possible. He gives thanks to Harry, who he says has sparked an interest in pure magic, real magic, strong magic. Harry Potter, the orphan child wizard, already famous in his own magical world because he survived the murderous black magic death curse of the evil Lord Voldemort, has now duplicated his fame in the real world. Under the category of children's fantasy literature, sales of Harry Potter books have received phenomenal acceptance worldwide, breaking all records in children's literature. With over 100 million books sold in 200 countries, Harry Potter has been translated into more than 40 languages. A massive global marketing campaign, partnered by Warner Brothers, Mattel, and Coca-Cola, guarantees that the Harry Potter image will be kept before the public for years to come, through films, toys, video games, and every type of merchandising product imaginable. According to a U.S. consumer research survey, over half of all children between the ages of 6 and 17 have read at least one Harry Potter book, with thousands reporting multiple readings of all of the books. These volumes range anywhere from 309 to 734 pages. While many parents are thrilled by the prospect of their children taking an interest in reading, other parents and educators view Harry Potter as the latest tool being used to disciple children into the darkest aspects of black magic. Through Harry Potter books and audios, children as young as kindergarten age are being introduced to human sacrifice, the sucking of blood from dead animals, and possession by spirit beings. Set in England, the Harry Potter story begins on Halloween night, with the murder of Harry's parents by the evil Lord Voldemort. Through the sacrificial goddess magic of his mother's love, baby Harry is saved, and his blood is given magical powers. Unable to kill Harry in revenge, Voldemort sears a death curse of a lightning bolt on Harry's forehead. In the real world, thousands of young fans demonstrate their allegiance to Harry by taking the mark of the lightning bolt on their own foreheads.
There's no such thing as magic.
Dear Mr. Potter, you have been accepted to Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry.
Harry is magically selected to attend the 1,000-year-old Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. Both Voldemort and Harry's parents attended the prestigious boarding school before him. All of Hogwarts' teachers are practicing occultists and instruct their students in the proper use of magic tools, spells, and rituals. Headmaster Albus Dumbledore owns a phoenix, the powerful mythological bird, the symbol of resurrection. The magical wands of both Harry and Voldemort share the same power, which is a tail feather from Dumbledore's phoenix. Therefore, in the world of Harry Potter, the power source of Harry's so-called good magic and Voldemort's evil magic is one and the same. The question is, should parents be concerned that the alluring power behind witchcraft is being made to look innocent and is being targeted towards their children through the Harry Potter phenomenon?